Hello, this is Brian Rowe with Mythic MTG Tech, doing a quick video here on the value of Liliana, whether you should be buying them or not right now, and on Patreon with regards to Magic the Gathering. There's several channels that are on it now, and I am looking at updating and improving my Patreon account so that it's more interesting for individuals here on the channel. Mostly I'm looking for suggestions. If you have any suggestions of tiers or things that you would like to see on there as possible stretch goals, I would really like to hear them. But let's start with the super fun one, which is Liliana the Veil. As people may have noticed, Lily hit a high of about $70 in April and has been slowly going down since. Most recently, we've seen a pretty good size drop as we're down to about $60 for TCG mid. So for a modern playable, amazing card, that's a pretty significant drop in price. We're talking about a 15 to 18% drop in price. More noticeable also, though, is the drop in the foil, which was at about $300 and is down to about $238. Giant drop. Why is this? Well, it's because the regional Pro Tour qualifier promo cards are Liliana the Veil. And it was just found out recently that it's not just Lily, it's a foil Lily with the original artwork. This has really hit the price of Lily pretty hard. I myself was caught very off guard with this. I was sure that Liliana the Veil was going to be a Modern Masters 2 Mythic, which might have been a small drop and then long-term growth, but not the type of drop that we've seen already. Now, that gets us to the question, should you be buying Lily now, or will she be dropping more? I believe that there's going to be a little more drop in the normal lilies, and we could see the foil lilies going down to about 175 or so if a lot of people qualify for these big regional events. This is going to be a replacement in people's cubes, especially since it's got the original cool artwork. Does that mean that I'm liquidating my lilies? No, but I'm also not trading them at the current price. If anybody wants my lilies, they're going to be in the 250, 275 range for them, because long-term, Liliana the Veil is a staple in a healthy modern environment. It attacks fair decks. It attacks combo decks. I'm really happy to have her. Long-term, I believe that she has more price potential than Jace. Jace being banned in Modern really brings down his long-term potential. So I'm holding my lilies even though they're dropping. If you're looking to buy, watch the prices over the next 2 to 3 months and jump in somewhere in there right after the lilies really flood into the market from those regional PTQs, because that will be your low point for Liliana the Veil's price. My second topic for today is the crowdfunding site Patreon and some of the Magic the Gathering YouTube channels that are currently on there, including Mythic MTG Tech. I wanted to talk just a little bit about what it is and then highlight three other channels that are out there and then ask for some advice on mine. I'm going to be revamping mine, changing the levels a little, maybe adding one or two more goals to it. If you have any ideas, I would love to hear those ideas. So for individuals who aren't aware, Patreon is kind of like Kickstarter, except it's for individuals that have ongoing projects that don't really have an end date. It is used by individuals putting together blog posts, videos, comics are very popular, music, something where it really makes sense to have a continual basis to it. Individual campaigns are run either by a monthly donation or a donation per work. So if it was done with a comic, that comic would end up getting donated to each time a new version of the comic comes out. If it's done in that incremental pattern, then individuals who are donating are able to put a cap on so that if double the amount of content comes out that you were expecting, you only cover the amount that you pledge to. I really like the system because it has a pretty good interface where you can interact with and follow your followers. You can produce exclusive content for them. I am not a fan of exclusive content. I am a fan of having previews. If I'm working on a slide deck, I'll throw the slides up there. If I need a topic, I will ask members who are on this forum if they've got any ideas for topics, and that's where some of my topics come from. I'm going to run through three other channels that are currently on Patreon, ones that I really look up to. Roxabox90 just moved over here, has very nice polished content, talks about pretty much everything magic related. I'm glad to see him over here. If you haven't checked out his YouTube channel, you definitely should. He is one of the better magic YouTube channels out there. The second one that I've got here is Limited Resources. Now, they have not been on Patreon very long, but they are a giant podcast. They do mostly limited, as it says, but videos around new sets as they come out, drafting them, that type of stuff. They started as a podcast, and when they reached one of their milestone goals here, they started to add videos as one of those goals. And I'm super happy to see them over here. They're just great guys are out of the Seattle area and very, very knowledgeable. If you're into limited, I would definitely check them out. The other series that has done really well on here so far is Evan Irwin's Forgotten Lore Magic the Gathering video history. These are, from a flavor perspective, some of the best videos that are out there. They just do a he does a really good job of looking up the history and telling you everything there is about a particular set. I think this is a great way to fund that type of project where there's an extensive amount of additional research in each of these well-done videos. If you haven't checked them out, I definitely would, especially for older sets when you might not have been playing. It gives you some very, very interesting history. So that brings us to Mythic MTG Tech. I've been on here about 9 months or so, and I kind of put this together just with as a way to show a little bit more about the philosophy of the channel, why I'm doing this, what matters to me. And I had a meeting with, it was actually a trade with somebody from the channel who had emailed me, asked if I had an extra Liliana for trade because they saw it on one of my trade videos. And I said yes, met them in the over at Card Kingdom, made a trade, and we talked about the channel for a while. And one of the things that he asked was, how serious are you about this channel? Where do you see it going? And on my Patreon, I kind of threw up there as a pie in the sky goal that $10,000 per month. But at that level, I would be willing to oversee and do this as a full production several days a week because I'm having so much fun with it. I don't know if I'll ever make it there, but that is how far I'm willing to go with this. Working on these videos does not feel like work. They are way too much fun. And it's something that I enjoy doing with the community, especially with the comments and feedback. I wanted to point out a few things about this campaign. One of the big things here that I strongly believe in is that all of the content that gets put forward will never end up being charged for. I will put all of my content out for free under a Creative Commons by license, which allows anybody else to remix, reuse, or share the videos as they wish, as long as I get credit as the person who originally created them. I am more interested in getting these out there than any type of hiding them behind the paywall, which is an option at Patreon. I'm not going to do that. I may have some exclusive things for patrons, such as a Google Hangout or the ability to vote on certain topics, but the end content that comes out of all of these videos will always be open. So at this point, I've got lots of different levels that I've been experimenting with. This level right here is just sold out, and I'm going to be adding them within the next week. It's a level where at the $2 per month, an individual gets a pack opening on the channel. I'm probably going to have another four or five of those available. I like to stagger them out over time because doing the pack opening videos is a little bit intensive. Plus, I have to get the mailing and all that stuff done. I don't want to get too far behind on those rewards because that is definitely the most popular level that people have started at. If you have any ideas for other stretch goals besides what are here, my first milestone was reached, which is a bonus commander deck tech. I've got the deck ready. I'm shooting that within the next week and a half. At the next goal that I've got here is to get a professional intro done. I've already reached out to a few people to look at what that would cost, and very excited about that. I may even start the Google Hangouts a little bit before that. I've been experimenting with it recently. At some point, I would really like to improve the audio setup that I'm using. The video setup is pretty good at this point, but audio would be amazing. If you have other ideas for either milestone goals or levels that you would like to see added here, interesting things, especially if they're just something fun or something that I can do on the channel, I'm more than willing to listen to those in the comments. Thank you, everybody who's out there currently on Patreon, and thank you guys for any type of ideas or feedback that you've got in advance as I start to try to improve this site and use it a bit more. It's working out really well for me.